I've been a lifelong exerciser, and that's ultimately what got me into what I'm doing now. Prior to what I call this career, because it has turned into a career, it's going on 16 years since I got into group fitness activity. Prior to that, I was a computer guy, IBM computer programmer, later years management of programming projects. Then IBM ended, and I still remained a technical guy, you know, computer related, more related to desktops and home computing and stuff. Taught applications a lot, Microsoft applications, did that for a few years, and ended up taking some classes, and that led to a full-time job, programming job, in Pemstar, which started back in the early 90s. And it was interesting because I was 65 years old, 66 years old or something like that. But what I saw it as is an opportunity to become a programmer again. And the technology was different. It was fun. Well, there's one thing, baby, that I want you to know. When you're rocking with me, don't rock too slow. I'm moving on and get toe-to-toe. We're gonna rock till we can't rock no more. Fred has been one of my instructors for about 5 years, and he is an inspiration to me. So when I get to be his age, I hope I have the same attitude and the same spirit. He lifts me. I'm always happy to come to his class. The group is a fun group. Everybody should come and do a class like this.
I've been doing this class for about a year off and on. I had some illness, and Fred's 1 year older than I am. And he keeps motivating me to keep doing things, so I really enjoy it. I've known Fred for about 25 years, and we work together at IBM, and Fred's an incredible person. He's very motivational, and he does an excellent job, and he's kind of the standard out here.
He's awesome, and if he can do this at 81, I can certainly do it at my age. He makes it fun in all areas.
So one day I came in, this was after I'd been there 7.5 years, this is 2006. I walked in, something didn't feel right, opened my desk like I did every day, I was going to get started, turn on my computer, and I sat there and my heart was telling me, something's different today, Fred. And I sat there and I said, you know what? So I got up, I walked into my manager's office, and I just said, I'm leaving. And he thought I was taking a half day off or something, you know, taking some time on it. He says, no, I'm gonna go back, lock my desk up, and I'm leaving. I'm not coming back, see you around. And I just walked out.
From the very start of meeting Fred, I was attracted to his energy. He's a very energetic person, and he, not only in his work, but in his play or in his hobbies of gardening and whatever he does, whatever new thing he learns to do, he does it with gusto. And the other thing that attracted me about him was his ability to, not only ability, but his tendency to share his feelings and share what's going on with him in his life, past and present. And I really respect that in a person, and I enjoy it.
It's probably about around 2006 or 7. I decided I wanted to develop my backyard. Around that time, I had no fence. It was just open to the woods behind, so we had a lot of deer come through. And critters, mostly deer, and they would eat anything I planted. So my first challenge was to fence off the property. So I just knocked around a little bit, and it was kind of like, now what are you gonna do with the rest of your life? Because I wasn't going to sit around and do nothing. First thing I did is collected all my computer books, put them in a couple boxes, ran an ad. I sold them to some young guy, programmer guy, for 10 bucks. Got rid of everything related to computers because I knew that's it, no more computers. And then it just sort of, at the time I was attending the RAC as a member, and I'd go to classes, you know, yoga, Pilates. And what started to occur to me as I would be in the class as a member taking the class, I'd watch the instructor and it was, I could do that. You know, it's like, I know what they're doing, I could do it. That's what dawned on me. So that was the first aha moment. It was like, maybe you want to do that. So I started pursuing, finding the path. How do you do that? So then I got the opportunity to go do a class at Community Ed. That was my first class. And I proposed it and they accepted it. And it went really well. I did that 3 times. You know, we did a fall, we did a winter, and we did a spring, 6-week session. Filled them up instantly, all right? So that was good feedback for me because it says, I think you might have it, Fred. This might work for you.
And you just feel it when you meet him. And it motivates others around him, I believe, including myself, to be more energetic and try new things. And I like that a lot about him.
Inspiring, ageless, and just in good shape. And I mean physically and mentally and emotionally. I don't know him that well to know about emotionally that, but if you're not emotionally well, you don't come and do this, you're not still working, you know. So I'm gonna guess physical, mental, and emotional, he's doing pretty good. It's a real role model.
I'm so impressed because over 16 years, I have seen hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people in fitness classes. And I've seen a lot of people, so I know. And I know how tough, that's the main thing, I know how tough getting and staying fit is. It's hard. That's why the majority of people don't do it. And I remind them, you people are in the top 0.000 percentile of your peer group and pulling it off. Pulling it off. Doing it. And the key to that, advice I would suggest to anybody is going to take on something new, whatever it is, a project, learning how to play guitar, this, that, woodworking, whatever, is don't beat yourself up. Just thinking about it and doing it, starting it, is pretty impressive.